Get ready to match the stars from MASH, Gary Berghoff, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Flew, from Family Feud, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game, PM! And now, here's the star of Match Game, PM, Gene Rayburn!
Hello, Johnny Olson. Thank you for joining us. We're going to have a grand time here because all of the people are gathered here. And oh, you are beautiful. You are a dandy-looking group. Would you join me in some brisk applause for our two players here, Kim Holliday and Leslie O'Brien Kinsey? Thank you very much. Hello. Now, we want to find out a little bit about each of you. And Leslie, we'll begin with you, sir. Tell us where you're from or anything you wish to contribute.
Currently from a compatriot of Richards.
Of what's his name? Yes.
Of Richards. From Great Britain.
Right.
Home of the Beatles, Liverpool. Currently living in Chino.
Yes.
I'm a mechanical engineer.
Uh-huh.
Currently resting.
Oh, unemployed.
That's right.
Between engagements, as
Between
we say in show business.
Yes, indeed. Whacker. And I'm married. I have three children, two daughters, a boy, and I have three grandchildren.
And they're all hoping you'll find a job soon.
Yes, indeed they are.
Well, you may through this program, you know, mechanical engineers. Someone may be watching who needs a mechanical engineer. Have you had experience?
So. Mechanical engineering?
Well, I know you've had experience.
Yes, indeed.
Got three kids. You must have been doing something all this time.
That's right. Yes, indeed.
Where did you mechanical?
London University.
Oh, splendid.
Yes.
Good. All right, Leslie. That's Leslie O'Brien Kinsey. Has a hyphenated name. Hello, Kim.
Hi.
Where are you from?
I'm from Los Angeles.
Yes?
Yes. I'm in flight attendant training right now with the major airlines.
Right.
I'm 23.
Yes.
Is there
something wrong with the chair? Something you're going... I'm 23. Fasten your seatbelt. Thank you, Jim. Okay, good luck to both of you here on Match Game PM. Each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of our beautiful people as possible. The one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. Go on and play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. Wowee. Okay, Leslie, A or B?
I'll choose A.
He says, I'll choose A, and he has A. Sandra said, I never should have married a gardener. Every night he brings his blank to bed. I never should have married a gardener. Every night he brings his blank to bed.
I love my answer.
Good. Charles was the first one finished.
That I can't believe.
Charles was the first one finished.
Wait, every once in a while we see beautiful acting. Isn't she wonderful? That was so real.
Yes. It might be really real. Okay, Leslie. Sandra said, I never should have married a gardener. Every night he brings his blank to bed.
Lawnmower.
Right. Okay. What do you say, Gary?
I think this is a match. Fruit.
Listen, close, Gary.
If it's good enough for Anita, it's good enough for me, fella.
What do you say?
I think this is the definitive answer. He brings his seed.
Aha! You didn't spend all that time in Encino for nothing. Hello, Charles.
Auntie Brett, explain that to me later.
No, just meet your hands.
I chose something sort of like close to home, Gene, for me. I said he brings his hose to the
okay.
Okay.
Joanne, I never should have married a gardener. Every night he brings his blank to bed, and Leslie said lawn mower.
Well, I didn't bring anything as funny as they all said. I brought something a little more dignified that I think might agree. A lawnmower.
There's one for Leslie. Good boy. Okay.
Very good. And I hope this is a match. Shovel.
No, I don't think we're going to match yet.
What?
You let your countrymen down Richard.
I thought he was going to say shovel. That's why. Yeah.
Just because he's from Liverpool, you thought he'd say shovel? No.
Marvelous. Scouse. Yes. From Liverpool. Scouse.
Yes, indeed.
Right.
I'm sorry I let you down.
All right. He'll
I'm
do
sorry
better
too,
next
Richard.
Time. Yeah.
Not as sorry as he.
What do you say, Fanny?
Well, personally, this guy was just a big cut up. I said he brought his pruning shears.
Pruning shears? Now let's see what we have for Kim. Here's Kim's. Judy said, it's tough having a practical joker for a husband. As a gag birthday present, he gave me a blanking bra. Tough having a practical joker as a husband. For a birthday present, he gave me a blanking bra. You're on your own. Hey. It's all ready. We're all ready. Everything's all right now. Here we go, Kim. Judy said it's tough having a practical joker for a husband. As a gag birthday present, he gave me a blanking bra.
Inflatable bra.
Inflatable. It's a difficult question for you, isn't it? Because she don't wear none. Hello there.
Well, at least this is apropos, even though it's not spelled it. I said a squirting bra.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, but only when she has her hand in her pocket.
Yeah, that would be a gag. That, you know those flowers that you put in your lapel, and then you have a little tube that goes in your pocket filled with water, and you squirt it, smell my rose, and go,
I think they got the picture, Gene.
Okay.
I get off of it as soon as you can.
Go.
Don't explain it, sweetheart. That's what Fanny has, an inflatable bra.
Oh, really?
Now, this woman happened to be 81 years old. It was not an inflatable, nor a squirting, nor anything. She was a true practical joke about her nursing bra.
Aha. Uh-huh. Well, that would be a gag. Yes.
A sagging bra.
A sagging bra. Okay. Super droopers before her time. Joanne. As a gag birthday present, he gave me a inflatable bra.
No, he didn't.
No?
No. This is a very difficult one. I said training bra.
A training bra. That'd be fine, wouldn't it? Well, we have all kinds of gags here. The reason I'm talking funny is I have a little sore throat. Usually I have a little deeper voice than this, but somehow something's happening to me today. Go ahead. As a tough having a practical joker for a husband, as a gag birthday present, he gave me a inflatable bra.
No, a mooing.
A mooing.
Now for half and half, it's burp burp.
Okay, Fanny.
Well, I couldn't think of an answer, and then, of course, I realized I share a dressing room with Brett. Training.
That's good. Okay, well, we have to end round one. Scores one another. Round two coming up after this. Hurry right back. All right, now let's go to round two here. And, Leslie, you're ahead, 1-0, so we'll ask you to go first.
Well, I had a little success with A before. Let's try it again.
Anything you say. Everyone except Joanne will play. Old Lady Perkins said, how, how, how. Well, old man Berrywinkle's been sneaking out at night and dating chorus girls. I just put a stop to that. Ha! I hit his blank. I hit his blank. Yeah, hit it. He couldn't find it.
Just put it away, didn't you?
Right.
Frankie, she's mean as a snake.
You're cute when you're mad.
day.
This old lady Perkins, Leslie, she said, old man Periwinkle's been sneaking out at night dating chorus girls, but I should have stopped to that. I hid his blank.
His genital.
His what?
Genital.
Genital. I hid his genital. Guys in your country don't talk too plain, Richard.
Don't you mess around with me, boy.
I thought he said his janitor in his
yes,
drum.
Come on.
I said his wheelchair.
Wheelchair is one. And the second answer is?
Don't come over me. Wheelchair.
Two wheelchairs. Chuck.
Say that again.
Chuck.
Pacemaker.
They're all good so far. Yours is excellent. And Richard, what do you say?
Dentures. Oh.
Fanny?
I was a young woman when I showed up for work tonight. Got to work on that diction. Brett just had a hot flash. Dentures.
Dentures. Okay. Now let's see how Kim does with her second round question. At the Chinese restaurant, Barry complained to the waiter. Waiter, this egg foo young tastes more like egg foo blank. At the Chinese restaurant, Barry complained to the waiter. Waiter, this egg foo young tastes more like egg foo blank. At the Chinese restaurant, Barry complained to the waiter. He says, waiter, this egg foo young tastes more like egg foo blank.
Old.
Yeah! Old is good. She says old. Would you help her?
Old.
You would help her. Score's tied 1-1. Brett?
I hate this word. Old.
Old. Yes?
Old.
Old. Well, look at what's happening here. You struck oil here, Kim Holiday. Joanne?
Yes?
This egg foo young tastes more like egg foo old.
Egg foo old.
Egg foo old.
Egg foo old.
Old it is. It's four for her. Now, you, what are you? You. A five. I'm Fanny.
Yes. Did you know that Brett took me to a Chinese restaurant that was so bad the fortune cookie said best to you in 68? Well, listen, I made a mistake. I said egg pew pew, and I don't know why.
Well, you can't come on here. Now, the score is 5-1. Kim, since you're ahead, we're going to ask you to go first.
I'll choose A, please.
A it is. One person plays, and that is you, Fanny. Are you ready? You're the only one.
What is the game?
Here it is. When Fanny Flagg roller skates, she falls down a lot. So she puts an extra pair of roller skates on her blank. Everybody who plays this gets a home version of the match game, and there it is. Thank you very much. Okay. Here it is. When Fanny Flagg roller skates, she falls down a lot, so she puts an extra pair of roller skates on her blank.
On her fanny, of course.
On her fanny. She says, on her fanny, of course. What do you say?
Well, honey, I was thinking that I was falling forward. And I said boobs. I'm sorry.
All right. Now that means, Leslie, you got a shot at it. If you match all five remaining celebrities, you can win the game. If you match four, we've got a tie. Here we go. Sheila said, yesterday, I went out with the $6 million man. And you should have been there. When I pushed my garage door opener, his blank opened up. Oh, that's a beautiful one.
Sheila said, yesterday I went out with a $6 million man. You should have been there. When I pushed my garage door opener, his blank opened up.
Quickly. Now, Leslie, here it is. Sheila said, yesterday I went out with the $6 million man, and you should have been there. When I pushed my garage door opener, his blank opened up.
His chest opened up.
His chest. That's the place where they opened up to do the maintenance and repair work.
Right, on that's it.
You got it all figured out, haven't
yes,
you?
Indeed.
Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. Two doors opened this way, just like that. Thing.
Leslie
now, all right. Leslie had a good answer.
Yeah, the right answer. He was wearing coveralls and his zipper opened up. Yeah.
His zipper opened. Now, Leslie, you got to match everyone else to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Brett, he's looking for a chest.
I love you, Leslie, and you're adorable, and I'm a great anglophile, and I'm sorry I said zipper.
Zipper. What do the rest of you have here? Kim Holliday wins the game. Oh, yay. All right. If you'll stand right there, I'll get to you in a minute. Want to shake your hand? I do hope you find a job soon, Leslie. It was a pleasure to have you. Got gifts for you. Leslie O'Brien, kids and ladies. Splendid fellow. Let's spin him off and spin a message or two just for you. Here we are with Kim Holliday, who's won the game, and she's going to have a go at the big money now. Time for this big money super match, and to do that, we're going to have two audience matches for you. And I point out to you, whatever you win in these audience matches will be multiplied by 10, and that'll be the final dollar figure you're playing for. Here we go. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best response to this. Cake blank. If you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, Kim, you get $500. If you match the answer they wrote down second most frequently, you get $250 and $100 for matching the third. And three of our six celebrities will give you some assistance.
A Richard, please.
Cake of soap.
Cake soap. All right.
And Fanny, please.
Something that Betsy did when she was a child. She told me the cakewalk.
The cakewalk. It's an old dance.
And Charles, please.
Cake plate.
Cake plate.
Now, there's no way you can
think it over carefully, Kim. You've got cake plate, cake walk, and cake of soap. Now, you can choose one of those or reject all of them and give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I thought of cake walk first.
Cake walk. Really? You have heard of that?
Yes.
All right, she wants cakewalk. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Cake and ice cream.
Oh, I wish I had some right now.
Oh, don't we all? May we see the next one, please? Cake mix.
Shows the world we live in.
I think it's a bad omen.
Tom mix.
What's that?
Tom mix.
Tom mix, that's right.
That
was
his
a
wife?
Baker. Yeah, that was his wife, Kate.
Cake Smith.
Yeah. All right, last chance cake for the cakewalk. Cake May walk. We see
Come
it.
Come on.
Yeah. Uh-huh. There we go. God. Wowee. Well done. Well, you picked the winner there. You've got $500, and that means the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. And now, Kim, we're going to see how much more you'll win with the second audience match. Here we go. Tale of blank. Tale of blank. Now, whom do you want?
Richard, please.
Tale of Two Cities.
Fanny, please.
Fanny, please.
Tale of One City.
Tale of One City. No! The Tale of Nine Tales? No, that's something unfortunate.
Cat of Nine Tales.
I think the Tale of Woe.
Tale of Woe.
Don't you?
And Charles, please.
Charles?
Tale of the Cock.
That's it. That's a famous restaurant chain here in Los Angeles.
Nurse!
Those are the three you have. Tale of the Cock, Tale of Two Cities, and Tale of Woe.
I'd like Richard's answer, please. Tale of Two Cities.
Tale of Two Cities is what she wants. All right, we'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Tale of the Deep South is
what
the first
the hell
one.
Is that?
I don't know what that is. I wasn't here that day. May we see the $250 number? Tale of Woe is the answer that Fanny gave you. Right. Last chance for Tale of Two Cities. Go! Oh, you did it! By Jove, you did it again. Now, you want another $500. We multiply that by 10, makes $5,000. Add it to the previous $5,000 you won. Gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for, Kim. And to collect that amount of money, you have to match one celebrity exactly.
Richard, please.
All right. Stand right there in that blue dot and face me if you would, please, there. And I will get the question worth $10,000. And good luck to you, and here it is. blank Boone, B-O-O-N-E, blank Boone. Okay, now he's finished. You give us the answer that he's written on the card. We give you $10,000. Blank Boone.
Daniel Boone.
Daniel Boone. All right, Richard. Daniel Boone is what she says will match you.
No, I can't do it, dear. I said Pat Boone.
Pat Boone. Did
you have it? He's just been in the news so much because his young daughter has a big hot record, really.
Oh, really?
And, yes. And I'm sorry, my
daughter. Oh, listen, can you have a total of $1,000, and that's not bad. We congratulate you for that. Now we got this for you. Listen, we thank you for joining us. We hope you'll join us next week when we'll have a lot more money to give away, and we'll have a lot more beautiful people, such as Gary Berghoff from MASH, and such as Richard Dawson from Family Feud, and such as our regulars here, and our semi-regular. Join us next time for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.